Hello friends, in this session I am going to explain you about back panel and front panel of the computer. First of all, we will see the power connector is of 3 pin which is located at the rear side of the CPU, and we also have the cable that is called power cable. One end of the power cable is connected to a rear side of the CPU, and another end of the power cable that is 3 pin plug is connected to AC mains, that is 230 volt in India. We can also see that beside of power connector, we have power supply cooling fan. This fan is used to bring out the heat generated in the CPU or SMPS. And the 3 pin power connector as well as the fan is a part of SMPS, that is switch mode power supply. Switch mode power supply is a device in a CPU which takes the AC power and convert it to DC, and also produces the required DC voltage for the various parts of the computer, that is in particular motherboard. Next is PS bar 2 keyboard and mouse connector. In this figure, we can see that these two connectors are located at the rear side of the CPU. The purple one is used to connect the keyboard and the green one is used to connect the mouse. We can see that it has 6 pins, and this type of connector is called as 6 pin DIN connector. DIN means dual in line connector. Usually in computer we have two types of connector. One is female connector and another is male connector. The female connector usually has holes, and in male connector we can see that the pins are projected outside. Whenever we have keyboard or mouse with USB connection, that time we require the converter, that is from USB to PS bar 2. The one thing I would like to highlight here, the PS bar 2 stands for personal system 2, that is meant for IBM personal computers. This PS bar 2 follows the IEEE 1284 Centronics port standards. The next one is serial COM port. Serial COM port is located at the rear side of the PC, which is of 9 pin. It is also in T shape. The male type of connector is available or located at the rear side of the PC, and the female type of connector we need to connect to it. This type of female type of connectors are available on modems, older mouses and PCs. Whenever we connect to serial port, it makes the communication serial. It sends the data bits serially with the speed of 115 kbps, that is kilobits per second. The VGA port, that is video graphics array, it is also of 16 pin connector. It is in D shape, and this female connector round socket is available at rear side of the PC, and this male connector is available at monitor. We have, while connecting the monitor to the CPU, this type of connector is used. USB popular connector. Nowadays many devices provides the USB connection. We will see what is USB. Usually we will have 4 to 5 USB connector on our computer. Here USB has 4 pins, we can see here, and it is female connector which is available at the rear side of the PC, and the male connectors are available on the different types of external hard disk, printers, scanners, mouse, keyboard and memory devices like pen drive, and it sends the data at the speed of 12 Mbps, that is megabits per second. We also have the audio ports. These ports are used when we want to connect microphone, speaker and audio processing devices. We have three types of female connectors here which are located at the rear side of the PC. The first connector, pin connector, that is used to connect mic. Second connector that is used to connect speaker, headphone or amplifier. And the third connector, the in, is also used to connect the external audio devices such as CD player, audio mixer, musical instruments and also a mic. We can see that the male connector is known as TRS audio plug. In this audio plug we have three rings, and these type of audio connectors are meant for computer. If it has 5 rings, that type of connectors are used for mobile devices. Now coming to the modem port. This modem port is located at the rear side of the CPU. First of all, we should know what is modem. Modem means modulator and demodulator. We know that computer sends or generates the data in terms of digital. If we want to send these data over a telephone line, we cannot send it directly. In order to convert the digital data to analog data, we need a device called modem. In order to connect the device called modem to our CPU, we have to use this female connector. And this male connector is taken from the telephone line or modem, and that is connected to this female connector in order to establish the connection to access internet. Now coming to the parallel port. This name itself indicates this sends the data parallelly. This type of connector, which is shown in the pink color, is available at the rear side of the CPU, which is of 25 pin DIN, that is dual inline connector, and it is of female connector. Now the male connectors, which are available on the different types of impact printers, namely dot matrix and line matrix printers, has this type of male connector. Whenever a user want to use the printer, he has to connect this type of male connector, which is available at the printer, and that connector has to be connected to a female connector, which is available at rear side of the CPU. It also follows the IEEE, that is Institute of Electrical Electronic Engineers 1284 Centronics port standard. Now coming to the Ethernet LAN port, that is RJ45. This port is very important whenever we want to access internet. We can see that this female connector is available at the rear side of the CPU, and this male connector usually drawn from a telephone line, a router or a switch or any other networking devices. This type of ports is used when we want to access the internet. We can see that this port is located at the outside or the rear side of the CPU. Internally, it is connected to network interface card, which is in turn connected on the motherboard. It supports the data speeds from 10 Mbps to 1000 Mbps. It is mainly used while accessing the internet or while connecting our computer on network. Coming to the expansion slot, we can see that the plain metal pieces are shown here. This is available for the expansion slot. Assume that we want to expand our graphics ability of our computer, then we have to add a graphics card, which is shown in the figure. This graphics card internally on motherboard is connected on the PCI slot, that is peripheral component interface slots. Whenever we connect this card on the PCI slot, this metal piece appear outside the or rear side of the CPU. Hence, this slots is meant for to add an extra add-on cards such as graphics cards, sound cards, network interface cards. Now coming to the thumb screw and security locks. The thumb screw and security locks are used while assembling and disassembling the PC. Now coming to the front panel of the computer. On front panel, we can see that from top to bottom, we have a CD or DVD drive. CD is compact disc, DVD is digital versatile disc drive. Whenever we want to read or write a CD, then we have to insert that disc into this drive with the help of this drive open button. And this USB ports. USB ports is universal serial bus ports, which are used by external devices such as keyboard, mouse, hard disk in order to connect to computer. Headphones and mic ports are also available on the front panel, and this is being used by headphone and mic port. In order to turn on the PC, we use power switch button, which is shown here, and reset button is also used in order to restart the computer whenever we stuck in any problem. And very importantly, we have two LEDs here. One LED, that is green LED, indicates the status of power supply, whereas red LED, which is shown here, it indicates the status of hard drive activity. Assume that we are reading or writing a file from hard disk, then this LED blinks and it indicates the hard drive activity. Now it's time to ask few questions to our viewers. Write your answer in the comment section of this channel and please let me know its answer. What does RS-232 stands for and what is function of SMPS, that is switch mode power supply, and how can tell the difference between USB 2.0 and 3.0? Well friends, hope you like this session. Please subscribe, like, comment on my channel in order to get regular informative videos. Thank you.